Hello, I'm David and I work for ITAS as a Sage consultant. In this video, I'm going to talk you through setting up e-banking in your Sage 50 payroll, making paying your employees easier.
To get e-banking set up, we need to go to Company, Settings, and click on the Bank tab. Down at the bottom, we need to click Enable e-banking. And then we need to download the relevant component from the website. We can click Change or Update Component. That will take us directly to the website, and it will give us a list of components that are available to download for any UK or Republic of Ireland bank. We scroll down the list of plugins until we find the plugin that we need. Today, I'm going to go with the NatWest plugin, which is RBS NatWest Internet Bank Line plugin. Click to do the download. Once downloaded, choose to open the file. And then follow the simple on-screen installation instructions. Dependent on the download, you may need to close down Sage 50 Payroll in the background. Some of them will run with the program open. If required, close the software down and retry the plugin. You may need admin access rights to be able to do the installation. If you do need these, please speak to your IT support. Once the plugin is installed, close it down and reopen up the Sage 50 payroll software. Going back to Company, Settings and Bank, tick to enable the e-banking, and then select the component from the drop-down list. You should see only one in the list. I have a few on there, as this is my demonstration set of data. Once you've selected the correct plugin, you will need to do some configuration. This is telling the software where you wish to save the e-payment file and what type of file extension you need to put on there. You can change the common directory. I am just going to put mine into the Documents folder. I would suggest a secure location on your network, on your PC, naming it Payroll e-banking file or something similar. You will need to speak to your bank to see what type of file extension they need on there and if they need any kind of file identifier. Once you've filled those in, click on OK and then enter your account name, account number, and sort code into the relevant fields. Bank's reference is optional. You can leave this blank if you wish, and then click on OK. We've now set up your company to produce the e-banking file. We need to make sure the employees are set up as well. Select the employee, go to Employee and Employee Record, and click on the Banking tab. Within this window, we need to select or enter the account name, the account number, and sort code. Again, Bank's reference is optional on this page. Last thing we need to make sure is that on the Employment tab, the payment method is set as Bank's. This tells the software to include this employee's payments in the payment file, and we can click Save. If you'd like any further information about setting up e-banking, or would like to discuss any of the elements of your payroll software, please get in touch.